When we were at our surge and peak in August and I was on service, I mean, and you can ask all the ICU attendings, the ICU nurses, do you know how many patients, as we were having conversations with them about needing intubation, now they need to get intubated and we're talking to them about it and they can't breathe and they're just, you know, gasping for air. You know how many of them were telling us, doc, please don't give up on me, telling their nurse, please don't give up, please don't give up on me. I wish I would have gotten my vaccine. I wish I would have gotten my vaccine. I'll get it now, I'll get it. For the first time in my entire career, that month of August, I saw nurses literally crying in tears as they were coding a patient. And you know, it's a combination of all the death and the loss that they experience and just sheer exhaustion. They're exhausted. They're working so hard to keep everyone alive. We don't want it to come down to that. We really don't want it to come down to that. The time to act is now. Hi, everyone. I have important information for everyone today, and I just really need you guys to listen and to understand. So the main question I keep getting asked is, why should I get a booster? Let me explain this. It's a combination of things. We have information now that's telling us that the immunity that we get from the vaccination series starts to diminish and it wanes down. A new variant plus waning immunity. Right now, the reality is you're not considered fully vaccinated until you're boosted and you receive that booster dose, and that's when you're gonna get all your protection. You know, people ask me all the time when I'm in the halls, when I'm in the wards. So why do I need? We're seeing people that are vaccinated and boosted that are still getting infected. They're still getting COVID. So why do I have to do all this? The vaccines are not like saran wrap all around you. They're not gonna necessarily keep you from getting infected, but we know that they are really, really good at keeping you from ending up in the hospital, and they are really good at keeping you from dying. Data from the CDC even goes as far as telling us that if you are unvaccinated or unboosted, you are 20 times more likely to die from COVID. If you're unvaccinated and unboosted, you are 17 times more likely to end up hospitalized compared to people that are vaccinated and boosted. These are really, really strong numbers. We continue to have high levels of virus circulating in the community because we have so many people that are unvaccinated and unprotected. So please, I'm asking everyone, go get your boosters. Please schedule your boosters right now. Have your family members, your coworkers, anyone that you can reach, and have them act now.